What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. I'm sure you can tell because I've been putting up consistent videos that I am a part of Vlogmas this year. Give me a pat on the back. I'm super excited about it. But I didn't have time to actually sit and film a video today, so I'm just making a video on the go. I'm literally on my way to the Mercedes dealership because I have to get something looked at on my car. But really quickly before I leave, I just wanted to make a quick video on increasing sales for the holiday season. Black Friday just passed and Allure 96 actually did amazing numbers this year, which is super awesome. And I kind of want to give you guys some tips and tricks that I used this year to increase some of my sales. Before I get into this video, I just want you guys to know that I will be having a webinar this December 14th. So go ahead and check the description box to see if you are interested in attending this webinar. Three amazing tricks that I used this holiday season for Black Friday and also Cyber Monday was, one, putting up a, what is it called? Like a time clock on my website, and I basically sent out newsletters. So I sent out newsletters a few days before the sale actually started, and then on the website I also went ahead and put up a stopwatch, and it was basically a countdown up until the sale actually started. Something else that I also did, I put up a really good sale. So my Black Friday sale consisted of every bundle deal came with a free closure, so you literally got a free piece of product, which was super awesome, and that's what created the biggest hype around my Black Friday sale. And then what I did for Cyber Monday was I had 15% off the entire website, and that also created an additional hype. I got the better outcome from the Black Friday deal than I did the Cyber Monday deal, but all in all, I did make a nice amount of money. Sales did increase drastically on that day, which was super awesome compared to last year. So some additional tips and tricks that I do want to give you guys really quickly are going to be creating a gift card option on your website. Create a tab on your website that offers gift cards, because something that I noticed was a lot of people did purchase gift cards to buy for someone else for the holiday season. And I think that's super awesome when you can go to a website, go ahead and purchase an actual gift card and, you know, give that as like a prize or a little gift. So if that's something that you are considering, I would definitely jump on that bandwagon because it's super effortless and it's a nice little gift that you can go, you know, it's a nice gift that someone can supply for someone else through your company. As far as marketing and promotion goes, when it does come to any sale, not just a holiday sale, but any sale, I recommend doing it between 3 to 5 days prior to the sale so that you can hype your customers up, create this major hype around this particular sale. So when the sale does drop, your customers will jump right on board and, you know, click on your website as soon as the sale is actually launched. When it does come to the holiday season, something that I also strongly recommend is actually marketing your products to the buyers and not your direct customers, because a lot of the times when it's the holiday season, like you guys know, Christmas is about to come up, Christmas Eve, New Year's Eve, a lot of the people that are in the purchasing mood are not exactly purchasing things for themselves, they're purchasing it for someone else. So I want you guys to, when you're sending out newsletters and things like that, be more direct. Use call to action when it comes to, hey, purchasing this for such and such, this would be an amazing gift for such and such, instead of actually directing each promotion and each newsletter and each marketing tactic to a specific buyer. Actually promote it to the gift buyers instead of your direct audience that you normally would. And then something major that I want you guys to look more into is your SEO, your search engine optimization. I want you guys to go in there, especially for the holiday season and the gift buying season, and I want you guys to use long tail keywords that people could possibly be using as far as buying gifts for others. So I want you guys to use things such as gifts for girlfriends, beauty gifts, things like that with longer taglines or longer tails, because that's typically what people are searching up this particular time of the year. And something major that I also want you guys to really be on top of your email game and on top of your phone support, if you do have phone support for your business, be super responsive, because a lot of the times people have a lot of questions around this time of the year. So make sure you guys are effectively responding back to everything, you know, accordingly and in a timely fashion. And the last few things that I want to say, one thing that I want you guys to look into, this really has nothing to do with actual gift buying or, you know, promotions or anything like that, but I also want you guys to really look into your return policy or your store policies to make sure everything is up to date, because like I said, for some companies this is the most booming time of the year. So make sure that your return policy, exchange policy, whatever store policies that you have are intact, because trust me, you're gonna have someone upset about something. You're gonna have, you know, it's always that one person that isn't 100% satisfied with the service. So you definitely want to make sure you have all of your policies intact, just to, you know, cover your behind in case something negative does happen to come up, which it's a 50-50 chance. It doesn't always come up, but you just want to cover your back in case it does. Oh my gosh, my arm is getting super tired. But the last thing that I do want to mention, and this is just a little tip for the holiday season, is make sure that something that can cut off a lot of contact time is if you possibly have some sort of shipping calendar on your website. So maybe for Black Friday, for instance, if you get a lot of sales, you want to maybe put on your website that, hey, all orders will go out on this particular day, or this particular on these particular days. You just want to make your life a little easier instead of harder when it does come to shipping out all of your orders and things like that. But like I said, the next big holiday is Christmas, so make sure you guys are paying attention to some of these tips and tricks that I am giving you, because it will help increase sales or boost your sales when it does come to the holiday season. But I literally have to get to the dealership right now, but I love you guys. Don't forget about my webinar December 14th. Go ahead and subscribe, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye.